Hi, I'm Joe Bev. This time on the Joe Bev Experience, this here is your life, Sherlock Holmes. But first, here's a Skype conversation I had with Doug McEwan, who co-authored the play with Daws Butler.
That particular show and that particular script that Daws sent to me, he sent me the script with the outtake, with all the material that didn't get used as well. And between the material that didn't get used in that, as well as things I liked in it, I pretty much built my whole career on it. Because I've used the characters and lines and various twists and perversions of them over the years, they've spun out like a seed, you know, growing into a tree. Because I do a lot of those characters. I change their names. A lot of those characters. And I was just listening to one, you know, before we start, I was just listening to one today because on this week's show, I'm going to be playing an old-time radio parody of the Green Hornet that I did back when Daws was still alive. And in it, there's two quotes. One is of Daws' quote from the Quick Draw McGraw and the Treasure of Sarah's Mattress Rip. Where he has Snagglepuss say, "I beg to differ. I'm a different beggar." That line, and then the other line was, "Get your hands off my person, you person!"
Right? Yeah, sure.
From Ben Wright saying it, and of course I had W.C. Fields saying it as he was trying to be the Red Hornet, you know, and. But they keep creeping in, and even on this week's
topic, having Fields doing the Red Hornet is more timely now.
Right.
After Seth Rogen's movie.
That's right.
Suddenly having a fat comic think that he's the Hornet has become new again.
Right. Well, yeah. So what I did it in 1982, at 83, and then I put it away for all those years, but I pulled it out this year because of that, and then. I had written it as a deconstruction of an actual Green Hornet episode. And so I pulled out that real Green Hornet episode, and I'm airing both back-to-back this week, and I'm calling it the Green Hornet meets the Red Hornet. So you hear the serious version, and then you hear the deconstruction of parody. So anyway, I live in the world.
Well, you talk about the material in there that didn't get used. Actually, we recorded all of it. The original recording was a full hour long.
I had some of it years ago. I think Daws gave me a 90-minute cassette, and on it was the hour show, and then another half hour of all of this extra material. And I don't know what happened to it. You know.
I don't know what happened to it. I had the hour show also, and I don't know what happened to it. I know why we ended up cutting it. We ran it originally at a Sherlock Holmes banquet. Society banquet up at the Yamamoto restaurant,
right.
And it was just too long. It lost the audience, and it was really clear that we needed to ruthlessly hack into it.
Yeah. Well, either way, I mean, it's just amazing because
plays much better in the shorter version. He said, knowing that much of the material that was hacked out was mine. Even so, it was better. Over the last week, since you gave me the link to it, I've sent it around and had friends listen to it that had never heard it before,
right.
And worried that well maybe the style was dated. I mean, it was very 50s, 60s, 70s style comedy. Everybody I've heard back from that listened to it was like, "God, that was funny! What a little party that was."
Who was Inspector Lestrade as Rodney Dangerfield?
Oh, those two voices.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.